Okay, welcome everyone to council meeting number 18, Tuesday, August 27. I'll call the meeting to order. We have regrets tonight from Councillor Runge, and I don't see Councillor Elliott on the Zoom call. He's not feeling well, so he may join us, he may not. Welcome back to our city manager, Byron Johnson. Good to see you again. I'll take this opportunity to recognize that we meet on the traditional territory of the Lhtako Dene Nation. Before I ask for a motion to approve the agenda, there is one late item, and that'll be under item or under M1 correspondence, Royal Canadian Legion Branch 94 requesting a resolution of support for their application to the New Horizons for Senior Program and Community Gaming Project grant for a new surveillance security system for the interior and exterior of the Legion building. So with that, could I get a motion to approve the agenda? Move Councillor Vick, seconded Councillor Goulet. All in favor? Carried. The next item that we have on the agenda is to adopt the regular the minutes of the meeting held July 30th, 2024. Mover? Councillor McKelvey, Councillor Rudenberg, all in favor, opposed, carried. The next item that we have is not really on the agenda, but I should have mentioned it. We have a certificate here for Lindsay. So I wonder, Lindsay, if you could, this is a certificate in local government service delivery to the from the Board of Examiners to Lindsay Blair, the certificate in local government service delivery in recognition of the fulfillment of the requirements for this certificate with all the rights, privileges in accordance with the regulations of the board made pursuant to the Local Government Act. So Lindsay, could you come up and receive this? Just come around to the front there.
So what does this mean, Lindsay?
Well done.
This isn't put in some time.
So we have no delegations. We have no items arising out of previous special closed meetings, no unfinished business, no committee reports, no council reports or discussion items. But we do have a couple of staff reports. And Lindsay, we're going to turn the floor over to you for admin report 94/24, the 2023 annual local government climate action program report.
Thank you, Mayor. This report is for information purposes only. The purpose of this report is to provide council and the public with a copy of the Local Government Climate Action Report for the city's 2023 greenhouse gas emissions. The Local Government Climate Action Program provides predictable and stable funding to support the implementation of local climate action that reduces emissions and prepares communities for the impacts of a changing climate. In 2023, Quesnel received $107,000 to support these initiatives. For 2024 to 2026, Quesnel will receive just over $313,000 to support climate action initiatives, including adaptation, mitigation, and resilience efforts. The program requires that municipalities share publicly the attached report on the city's greenhouse gas emissions and climate actions. Greenhouse gas emissions are measured in tons of CO2 equivalent. In 2023, the city's greenhouse gases were 1,153 tons of carbon equivalent, which is a 12% decrease from 2022 due to a warmer winter and lighter snow at the start of the season. And this report is for information purposes only.
Okay, thank you. I'll open the floor up to any questions from council. I noticed that as I go through the report that there's a lot of reference in there to the fact that we can't really proceed further on certain aspects because we don't have the funding and we don't have the technical expertise and so on and so forth. And I would imagine that the city of Quesnel is not alone in that respect, that many other municipalities and regional districts, and I'm sure First Nations as well, are awaiting further funding and so that they can move forward. Would that be a fair assumption?
Yeah, that's correct. And we here at the LG Cap Forum in Vancouver this year, we heard a lot of municipalities are saving their money year after year in order to do some large projects, but many municipalities are also using their funding to contribute to other granting so they can build on the funding. And we're actually doing that with some of this year's funding. Once we get the application in, we have a grant application. I think it went to council in January or February, I can't remember, but it's for a greenhouse gas building portfolio to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and that'll be a $250,000 project, and $50,000 of these LG Cap funds are contributing to that grant. So we are using the grant to build on other funding, and we have more plans in the future to move things forward.
Great, thank you. Any questions? Okay, we'll move on then to item two under city staff reports. And this is admin report 33C24, 530 Carson Avenue update, Director Turner to report.
Thank you, Mayor. This is just a information report again for council. It's really to keep you up to date on the progress of Grace Inn. As it went to zoning, we did promise that we would keep you up to date in terms of the redevelopment of this property. It was understood that there was some concerns, and there has been a number of concerns from the community regarding some of the activities currently on this location. The promise was that we would try and get buildings removed as quickly as possible, and that was a promise to the Downtown Association as well as secure the site. And this is the progress that we are where we are to date on this. BC Housing is attempting to work very quickly in order to get some buildings down and the temporary housing in place so that we will have a sort of a new site by November of this year. So you'll see in the reporting there that there's a couple of buildings that will come down first. It's the old pool house with the red roof on it, as well as building two, and the site that will be the site location for the temporary housing. That whole area on that side of the alleyway will be fenced, and they will utilize building three for office space and community space, laundry, etc. And that will be sort of the temporary housing site. Well, the construction of the supportive housing will occur on where buildings four and five occur. Once that other site is secure, they will begin demolition of buildings four and five. And then the supportive housing will be constructed as soon as possible. They're already sourcing the buildings for this site actually have them in reconstruction. Under reconstruction, they will be modular units that are brought in for a very quick resurrection of that supportive housing building. On the plan that's in your package there, I do list out sort of the phasing for the full redevelopment of it, of the site, which includes phase two, which is the redevelopment of where the current or where the buildings one through three are and where the temporary housing will go. Once the supportive housing is up, the remainder building three will be torn down, and we will hopefully be developing something there that we've already been planning. So the intention, as soon as we start building the supportive housing on four and five, in fact, right away currently, we're going to start having discussions with the housing solutions table on what type of housing ought to go into this new space and how we ought to utilize that new space for housing and to interact with the rest of the area. Is there any questions?
Yeah, any questions from council? Because this is a for information only item, we don't need a resolution to receive it? No?
I would appreciate you receiving it for sure. I just want to make sure the council is being kept up to date and the community is being kept up to date as to what's going on in this property. So receiving it would be appropriate.
Okay, so you'd like to have a resolution?
Yeah,
Councillor McKelvey is going to move it and Councillor Rudenberg is going to second it. Any discussion? All in favor, opposed, carried. Okay, thank you for that. Now we go to our council information package, and no one has asked that we bring anything forward from that. And we do have that late item under correspondence from the Legion, and I'll just quickly get to the gist of that, and that is that they would, they're requesting council's approval or council's blessing on a grant application. They are applying to the Seniors Program and Community Gaming Project grant funding to acquire a new surveillance slash camera security system for the interior of the building and the exterior perimeter of the parking lots to cover the property and neighboring properties. Cost is approximately $30,000. The granting agency requires a letter of support for such, and the Legion is asking that council provide that to them. So if we could get a motion to that effect, Councillor Vick, Councillor Rudenberg, any discussion? All in favor? Opposed? Carried. Okay, that's that one out of the way. And we do have one item under bylaws, and that is bylaw number 1967, City of Quesnel 2024 to 2027 permissive tax exemption amendment bylaw 1967 of 2024, going for final adoption. A mover, please. Councillor Vick, Councillor McKelvey, any discussion? All in favor? Opposed? Carried. Thank you. We have no changes to our upcoming, we have no new business. We have no changes to our upcoming meeting schedule. We have no changes to committee appointments. I'll open the floor now to announcements and events. Councillor Goulet.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And just that we have the upcoming powwow this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Starts at 7 o'clock on Friday at the Arbor at La Taco. It goes on Saturday at noon, it starts, and then Sunday noon till whenever they wrap up, usually about 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. So everyone's welcome. It is an open event and should be fantastic. I know there's some food vendors and vendors that have taken the time to come out. Lots of drummers from out of town. We've had quite a few from the Alberta area, so very excited and very proud to be doing the 50th and first powwow at La Taco Arbor, the new arbor. It's a first for them, so we'll see how that goes. It's their first actual event since they built the arbor, so that's exciting as well. So everyone's invited. All are welcome.
Okay. Well, most people are welcome. Thank you. So is there anything more? Under announcements and events. Okay, I'm going to open the floor now to gallery questions. Going once. Come on up, RJ. You know the drill. Your name and your address. And it's got to be a question pertaining to the what was on the agenda.
Hello. So my request would be under announcement. So I'm not sure whether you'll accept what I want to say, but it's to do with four subject and to do with thanking our city manager would be one of my thank you, Baron, because I hope I'm not out of order here, because all I'm doing is bringing event much like Tony just did, basically. So if I'm okay, if you're okay with this, then I'd like to continue.
Keep going until I shut you down. So,
okay, thank you. So, Baron, thank you for your service. I wish you the best on your new jobs. It's kind of sad to see you go, but however, life change, and I guess you have to do what you have to do. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
My second one was Bert Deving get-together, his service, which was absolutely fantastic. Mike Nelson and Ed Friesen were the host, and it was just a wonderful gathering, a nice tribute to Bert, and there was so many good speech done. And I was just floored. I just had to bring it to the city because, you know, this man has been, you know, quite positive about our town and whatnot. Number three is Fire Smart. This was a program that was done in conjunction with the city and Fire Smart, and I participated big time on it. And I'd like to thank you, to thank Ted Trier, which was the instigator or the head of this, along with you, Ron, and whatnot. And they helped me with a $1,000 check, which I received. Mind you, I spend a lot of money on remodeling my place and whatnot. The last but not least is the Downtown Association, which are doing such a fantastic job every Thursday with the music. I can't say enough about all these people who and the band and so on. And Lily and I thoroughly enjoy it, and we dance, and I dance with several different people. And I think it's so positive. It's just about, you know, it's about our town and who we are and what we do. Beside working, it's entertainment at its best. And you see these young, talented musicians and older folks, too. It's just so positive. I personally just, I'm really touched by it all. So thank you very kindly for listening to me.
Thank you, RJ. You were kind of borderline as far as being in order is concerned, but I'm feeling very benevolent tonight, so thank you.
Mr. Mayor, to...
Is this the question that we've been waiting for?
No.
Actually, just to be clear, those announcements are announcements that come from the council table. So, no, you're completely in order as far as approaching us during gallery questions, because that's the time that the gallery gets to ask the questions. But I searched hard to really find questions in your presentation, but it was good and it was well appreciated. So thank you, RJ.
Thank you very much.
Councillor Rudenberg.
Thank you. And I think what RJ is asking is if there's an opportunity to look at our procedure bylaw so that at the end of meetings, if people who are in the gallery have announcements that we've missed as council, if they are allowed to speak. So it might be something that policy and bylaw can look at about whether or not we have announcements that come from the gallery. I think that's what you're asking for, correct?
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Okay, so we'll have to send that to our policy and bylaw committee for discussion.
Yeah, you and I talked about it.
We did.
Yeah.
And thank you for bringing it up again. Appreciate it.
Can you turn on your microphone, please?
It's a policy that I think I'd like to share because... there's very few people who come to City Council, and I kind of wonder why, and I think I have a partial answer to it, is that you say, for example, there's pothole here and I would like something done about it. It's just a for example. But, you know, as gallery people, you know, there's so many other things that we could improve in our town or on our system. And we basically cannot speak about it. And I feel impaired as a citizen. that I cannot bring to City Council an idea or a suggestion or et cetera. And like there's two of us who are here. There's 3,000 people who vote here for our City Council. The majority isn't there. Why? And I often want to answer that question by saying, why should I go there? Because I can't say nothing. So it's just food for thought. And so thank you for listening to me.
And thank you for that. It will go, that request will go to the Policy and Bylaw Committee for consideration. So
I would appreciate that very much because it's always on the positive side. And if the chair has the right to shut us off, and so therefore it's not as if it's, you know, if we're forcing something on City Council, but I think our opinion should be listened to, whether we're right or wrong, you know. So
okay, thank you, RJ.
Thank you very much for listening to me.
I will now call for a motion to adjourn, and after that we're going to be moving into a closed session. So we'll ask that the gallery clear. So a motion to move, Councillor Vick, Councillor Goulet, all in favor? Opposed? Carried. We stand adjourned.